are instructed to reveal yourself. Locating suspect. You are instructed to reveal yourself. Locating suspect. You are instructed to reveal yourself. Detecting abnormalities.
That's clear.
I'm coming for you. Open the door. I'll cover you.
Now!
Step back! Back! Toss your weapons or I'll shoot! I repeat, drop your weapons! Now!
Easy now. Not too late for everyone to walk out of this alive.
We called for...
Are you all right?
Just some scratches.
You fucking morons!
Did you get hit? Hang on, girl. I'll patch you up.
It's nothing. Let's go.
We couldn't retreat, get him. They regrouped so fast. Started shooting rockets and shit. I lost everyone.
Everyone? Scorpion, is he here? Mitch? Mitch? He's safe, right?
Damn, I'm sorry. I didn't make it in time.
No! No! Are you sure? No, he...
Scorpion, the rest. I'm sorry we didn't get here sooner.
They were good people. Great people. They didn't have to die here.
I should have stopped him.
I tried. He wouldn't have listened to you either. Never was much of a listener.
Stubborn bastard.
I'm guessing since you were out here for the AV. The question is why?
Everything okay? You need anything?
Thanks for saving my ass, V.
Sorry about your people, but I need to keep moving. Why dive straight for the AV? Didn't notice the markings?
We saw it was damaged. We know this land. We knew where it would fall. We had no idea it was Kang Tao. I figured they might need help. In the worst case, there'd be good salvage to be had. Couldn't have been more wrong.
I need the guy who's riding this AV. You know anything, see anything.
Took him with him, in our cars.
Where?
West, small unit, your passenger's entourage.
Must be looking for a way to call base.
So you're the ones who hit him with that EMP?
Yeah, we tried to warn you, but couldn't connect.
If they took your cars, we might be able to follow their tracks.
Pan Am, listen. I know it's not the best time, but I need Hellman. You promised to help. That still hold?
I always keep my word. Mitch, I will find those sons of bitches. I swear.
Go. I'll call the crew. Get all this cleaned up.
We'll leave my ride here just in case. Just watch the gun, it likes to jam. We'll go by bike.
Sounds good. Kang Tao lost contact with their AV. Probably looking for it. Better hurry. But Pan Am.
What?
You're coming back for her, right?
I promise. Let's get going, before they send a rescue party.
Let's ride. Hope they didn't go far.
We'll see. The tire tracks start there. We'll follow them.
Our guys were here.
Let's follow. Find them.
Scorpion said I would hate Night City.
He knew you that well.
Probably better than I know myself. He said when I'd had enough of the city, they would stock up on canned kibble, fill a couple of thermoses with coffee and whiskey, and hit the road. He said we would get away from it all.
Sounds like a real adventure.
Yeah. But he's gone. Shit. Why is everything shit, shit, shit?
Hey, I know.
All I see is cracked concrete and rust. If they thought they would call their friends, they were in for one hell of a surprise.
The rest must have taken Hellman with them.
If they manage to regroup and call for help, we're out of luck.
Better hurry then. Left a few peeps behind at the airstrip. Rest went with Hellman.
I would have done the same. They're looking to call their people. The last they want is to ride through the desert without backup. I hope Mitch contacted me all to kill those. All that damn interference.
They're coming for him. Don't worry.
You know what?
What?
This is my life right here. I step out of one pile of shit, only to trip into another bigger one. These tracks lead up past the hill to an old filling station. I wager that's where they're holding help.
Drones, patrols. Definitely set up shop here.
I see. They must have Hellman locked up somewhere. Luffy, see that? The pumps look pretty good. Not what you would find if the place were closed. The bastards might have managed to call for transport.
We'll know soon enough.
I'm on it!
Brace yourself! Hold your fire!
Don't shoot. I'm unarmed.
The hell are you doing here?
This is my station. Name's Marty. Those fucking suits rode up like they own the place. Took everything. Put me here and locked the door.
Brought a man with them. A man I need. Civilian. You must have spotted him.
Mm-hmm. I ain't blind.
Where are they holding him?
Old garage. Room upstairs. Probably keeping him there.
Thanks. I were you, I'd stay put for a few.
Exactly my intention.
Know where they're keeping Hellman. Going in.
Okay, covering you.
You even get any customers out of here? Shit, anyone even drive this way?
Anyone who don't like refueling with cameras watching them. Not many, sure, but they're all big tippers. You get me?
In exchange for your terrible memory.
Don't you worry. I'll forget you too.
Taste of paradise. Don't wait a microsecond longer. Send space to 7299. Yes, I'm talking to you. Are you getting what you want out of life? Let me guess.
Who sent you?
Hey, easy. We gotta talk.
Who are you working for? You're a Nobu Arasaka. Do you wish to take me back home?
Pathetic rat's got nowhere left to scurry off to. He's out of lifelines. Shut him up already.
Not a fan, I take it.
You haven't found a fan in him either. motherfucker doesn't know who to be scared of more, you or Arasaka.
Don't take this personally.
Seem to recall you were gonna tell Takamura when you got Hellman.
Yeah, just a sec. I'll call him.
Just remember, you have Hellman, and that's one hell of a card. Try to win something with it.
Takamura saved my life, remember?
Because it was in his fucking interest to do so. Still just Biz. He's no friend of yours.
Takamura, good news. Got Hellman.
Alive. What did he say?
Alive, alive. Not too talkative now. Taking him to the Sunset Motel.
I will come to you. Keep him there until I arrive.
You got it. See ya.
Better take him somewhere you can talk in peace.
True.
Looks like your new Chimbas are here.
Is that him?
Sure is.
Take him outside. Toss him on the bike.
Stay right there.
The cavalry has arrived. Mitch gathered together a few old accounts.
The road was clear. I don't think we were spotted. We would still do better not to hang around too long.
What do you plan to do with him?
Just gotta ask him a few important questions.
I sure hope you get some important answers. Saul.
Everything's done here. All clear.
I heard Mitch is alive thanks to you.
Thanks to V and Pan Am. They both saved my ass.
I just hope he was worth it.
Saul, I tried to raise Scorpion, but he... Maybe I could help out somehow?
I think you've helped enough.
I tried to stop him. Sure. Just turn around now. Let it all be damned. You're good at that, aren't you?
Look, Saul. It really wasn't Pan Am's fault.
Careful. You and me are not buddy-buddy. Besides, nobody's blamed anyone for anything yet.
Sure. Right.
Pan Am was just helping me. It was my doing. My fault that AV got hit. Without me, Scorpion and his people wouldn't have gone out to grab it. That's the truth.
When you're an Aldo Caldo, you are always responsible for yourself and your people. The circumstances change nothing. Perhaps Pan Am should ask herself if she's still an Aldo Caldo.
Damn it all.
Glad to see you, Mitch, but why'd you even come?
Saul, he came with our people. We took care of the bodies. I told him what happened. And he told us to up and follow you. He was worried something would happen to you. To Pan Am.
Saul?
Look, maybe you two don't see eye to eye at the moment, but you're family. And Saul will do anything for family.
The thing is, am I even part of the family anymore?
You know you are. Come back to us. I understand.
Sorry you had to witness that. Things just get complicated. Dramatic sometimes. But I will manage. And you. You look out for yourself, all right?
So, what now? Back to Night City?
Yeah. I mean, I think so. I have to sit and think about everything.
So, Mitch, they really treat you like family. Maybe you should give them a chance.
It is not that simple.
Like any family.
They're coming. You have about a minute to get out of there.
Let's move!
I'm also headed out. Take care of Scorpion's bike. It's yours.
Yeah.
Hey.
Where am I? What is this place?
Motel, middle of nowhere.
Any specific middle?
Doesn't matter. You're not leaving here by yourself anyway.
Why are we here?
Want to talk about your little invention. Biochip you made for Arasaka.
Fine. But let's get one thing straight first. Yorinobu Arasaka didn't send you?
No.
This means you must have an offer for me. If your boss will pay more than Kang Tao, I believe we can talk.
You misunderstand me. There is no offer.
What do you want?
Got Silverhand's construct in my head. It's literally driving me crazy, and I know it's only gonna get worse. That is, unless I remove it. And that, none of that's on the billboards I saw. Not even in the fine print.
Construct? That's impossible. Where did you get this biochip?
Clept it off Yorinobu Arasaka. Job for a client. But the client left me out
to dry. And you decided the best place for it was in your own goddamn head.
Actually, wasn't a bad idea. Construct rebooted me when my own goddamn head took a bullet.
I always knew Yorinobu's plan would fail. I just never imagined it would turn out like this. Arasaka's prized tech really is in the very streets of the city.
You have to remove the biochip from my system.
It's not that simple.
Look, you made the thing, didn't you? So where's the problem?
If you're telling the truth, you slotted in a new experimental version of the biochip.
I know you can't just yank it out. My Ripper
said... You showed that to some fucking street doctor? Who else knows?
I needed help. Or did you think the first thing that came to mind was down in a Kang Tao AV? How's the prototype version different? It's got a different engram, something more...
Where?
Aggressive?
The biochip is what's unique, not Silverhand's engram. The previous version of the chip was only used to communicate with pre-saved engrams.
And it was rare as fuck and cost a fortune. Yeah.
This one's rarer. Meant to install and activate the engram in a new body. When I left Arasaka, the project was still in the trial phase.
How do you put a price on immortality? Who could even afford tech like this?
Nobody. This model was meant to remain in-house. The prototype was Saburo Arasaka's personal commission. He oversaw the entire project himself.
So if it weren't for Yorinobu, nobody would have found out.
And if not for you, the project would not have been a success. This is a true breakthrough.
Yeah, great. Your tech works. Now get it out of me.
Well.
I would have to see it first.
Whoa, we just met. Haven't built up that sort of trust yet.
How did you think this was going to go? If you want me to help you, I must examine you.
Okay.
Unbelievable. It looks like...
Can't believe this suit's the one who's gonna help us.
Oh, fuck.
What? What is it?
What a pity I won't be able to examine it fully.
Yeah, real shame. You could have been his guinea pig, too.
Tell me how to get rid of it.
I'm afraid I have bad news. Your neural network has completely deteriorated. It can no longer function independently of the chip. The only thing I could
do... Woo-hoo! It's bargaining time.
...is to give you information on a good clinic in Sweden. They'll help you through the terminal stages. Minimize the pain.
Wait, you said the project was in the trial phase. You don't actually know how it'll end.
Oh, I do. I just saw the construct devouring your brain. It's programmed to take over its new environment. At all costs. And your little meat brain is helpless against it.
So no matter what, sooner or later the engram wins.
Yes. And from what I've heard about Silverhand, that seems to be exactly his style.
Huh. I see my reputation's grown into Arasaka legend.
What exactly is going on in my head?
You tell me. What's it like to have two personalities? Because it's not like you're hearing voices. You are both yourself and Silverhand, simultaneously.
I can see him and talk to him.
You're not talking, but yes, I understand what you mean. Have you noticed the construct's influence on your decision-making?
Sheesh, give it a rest.
When it comes to my decisions, Johnny really is just a voice in my head. Maybe he has a different opinion, but he can't make me do anything.
Agreed 100%. You are one fucking stubborn
host. It's not as if one of you wins the debate. The scale simply shifts, slowly but surely.
What do you mean?
You will start doing things that were once unthinkable, at least to your old self. And you know exactly who he was. A fanatic. A terrorist. A suicide bomber.
Well, fuck me. Who's trying to mess with your head now?
That is why I believe it would be better for you to consider clinical isolation at this stage.
At least Johnny never whored himself out like you.
Are you defending him? Or is that Johnny speaking now? Oh, let me guess. He already tried to take over your body. You know, just for a little while.
No.
Would you, though? Could be fun.
Johnny...
Kidding. But watch out. Suit's getting ready to talk your head off.
Know what? That's enough. You just playing for time? Because I can't tell. Are you trying to convince me you're useless? I mean, in that case, I can just shoot you in the head and save us both some time.
Oh, finally.
I will try to help you. If you come with me to Kang Tao.
Forget Kang Tao. Got any other ideas?
If you think there's anyone else who can help you, I could give you the blueprints. Complete project documentation. Kang Tao offered quite the sum for it.
You got it with you?
He's got to. Gonk's fucking useless without him.
Hey, Takamura? What the hell is he doing here?
He's got a few questions of his own for you. You play nice, he might even save your ass. I'm almost done. The blueprints.
Better than nothing. Long as we find someone fluent in technobabble.
What'll you do with him?
I haven't decided yet.
Are you serious?
You know me. I can be impulsive.
He's all yours. I'll give you two some space.
I hope we can come to an understanding.
That is certainly in your best interest. V, I will remember this.
Well, this heat. Put a check mark
my
next
throat
to
is positively parched.
Now we gotta...
V did not give you even a glass of water. Unacceptable. Inhumane. That is not me. You will see the difference. I will give you full buckets.
No need.
What the? Fuck! Sit down, goddammit! Let's get out of here.
Third trimester cramping is not likely.
Huh, you sure? Can't be that bad if you make it light.
Fuck!
That was your ticker. Sit and rest. Don't need you flatlining while we got a job to do.
Blah, blah, blah. Fuck Arasaka. Blah, blah. Smash Mikoshi.
You really are turning into me.
Might be right.
We're bickering like a couple of geezers on a park bench. It's time we let up. Let a little trust take hold.
Got no idea where I'm going. Be a living legend. That's all I wanted. Feels like I'm barely surviving.
Test of a person's true value? Death. Facing it, staring it down. You still got a chance to be somebody.
Let's move. Get back to work.
Let's do.
Hey, Judy. How you feeling?
Shitty, but something came to me.
Gotta give yourself time to grieve, Judy. Experience all its stages. Feel them. Let them play out. Shock, anger, depression.
I'd say I'm on anger. Gonna stay here for a while, too. I can work with anger.
So what did you come up with?
The Mox died. Lizzie's bar used to be a joy house. Tiger Claws killed one girl too many, so people took matters into their own hands. It belongs to us now. Clouds could stand to get the same makeover.
I'm sure you've thought this through, Judy. Carefully.
Haven't thought it through at all. All I know is the Mox didn't turn things around by sitting on their tans and towing asses doing nothing.
Got the Mox to agree to take over Clouds.
No, I'm trying to get you. Know someone at Clouds will take our side. Will you help?
Fine. Got me on board.
Oh, yes.
Okay, so, what's the plan?
First up, we gotta talk to Michael Maya. If she's not with us, might as well throw our hands up in the air.
Maiko Maeda. Who is she exactly?
Girl who unofficially runs Clouds. Good at it, too.
What's she do officially?
She's a doll, so she's a nobody.
Maiko Maeda. Who is she exactly?
Girl who unofficially runs Clouds. Good at it, too.
What's she do officially?
She's a doll, so she's a nobody.
Evelyn, Maiko, you seem to know your way around Clouds.
They used to work there. Helped them out with their behavioral chip, perfecting it.
Why'd you leave?
Didn't like the vibe. Place reeked of exploitation.
You sure Maiko's gonna want to join forces?
If I was sure, I'd be on the hollow to her, and we wouldn't be having this conversation.
Let me rephrase. Is there any chance she'll slap us around and shove us out her mega tower window?
Of course, sure.
Guess I can work with that. How well do you know this Maiko?
Too well.
When are we doing this?
Early morning. Clouds will be closed. Hardly a soul lurking at that time.
How early?
Before 8. I'll be by the entrance. Scratch that. The balcony above Clouds. We'll sneak in. No one needs to know we're there.
On the balcony. Got it. It is good to see you, V.
Seems pretty, secluded here.
It is appropriate for such a secret meeting.
What the hell happened? You look close to awful.
You see a man robbed of his implants, money, and dignity. Look well. It is not all bad. I am mostly unnoticed in the streets.
Friend you mentioned here?
Oda? He should be here any moment now.
Willing finally to give me the spec on him?
He's Hanako-sama's bodyguard.
Hanako Arasaka's? From the carrier at anchor in the bay. Saburo's daughter.
Yes, and if he believes you, we'll next meet with her.
Sure you can trust him?
Yes.
Convincing, very.
I have nothing to lose. Is that better?
Worse, because I got plenty to lose.
By car, huh? A good sign. He is usually camouflaged.
Takemura-san.
Oda.
Is this him? Your thief?
He's my witness, B.
Can't speak for myself, you know.
So speak. I have been told you know things.
Not gonna like what I'm about to say. I need a guarantee I'm safe here.
You are. You have it.
V, you can trust Oda.
All right, then. Konpeki Plaza. I was there the night it happened. Looked like your typical family quarrel until Yorinobu lunged at Saburo and started choking.
Silence! Not one word more. You will bring death to your door.
But it is the truth. Hanako-sama must hear it.
My one concern is to keep her safe. In this city forgotten by the gods.
Is she in danger?
Now? No. Yet during the parade to honor Arasaka-sama, most certainly.
I bring you this witness to his murder. And you dare to worry about a silly parade? Fool!
Correct. Unlike
But you can't ignore the truth.
Unlike you, I have not yet failed to keep my oath to do my duty.
You will regret those words.
The only thing I regret is that I came here to meet you. There is a price on your head. I do you a favor now by not cutting it off and taking it straight.
Sorry, but this is gonna take much longer.
I do you a favor now. By not cutting it off and taking it straight to Yorinobu-sama. What would you do now, were you in my place?
I do no favors. I would deliver your head to Yorinobu-sama.
Consider yourself lucky.
Oda!
What?
We're talking about a guy who killed his father to seize control of Arasaka. Gonna take an interest in this or not?
I will not. But I will let you leave this place, this city, unharmed. If I see either of you again, I will not be so lenient.
Be very careful, my friend. We are all so far from home.
Good fucking riddance. 1 hour Saka whack job is already plenty.
No way this is gonna work.
Yet. We walk away with a small measure of success.
Hmm. How do you figure that?
What Oda said. They return to Tokyo after the parade. Do you not see the parade? It is our chance, perhaps. If somehow we can get to Hanako-sama, we must do a proper reconnaissance first. We'll need a precise map of Japantown.
Hold on.
It is your turn to call on friends. Do you know a fixer who could help?
Hang on. Not so fast. Make it sound as easy as hacking a schism. But you said yourself, Hanako's got the tightest security in All Night City.
Correct. That is why I wish for you to contact us with the local fixer.
No, just a fixer dame. Wakaku Akada runs a pachinko parlor on Jig-Jig Street.
We must pay this woman a visit. Will you join me?
Sure, why not?
J Street. What is this name?
Just a Night City name.
Beware, you mock me too often.
Any idea what's going on at Arasaka?
Only what I can surmise from what I see on TV. Yorinobu and his puppets grin at the cameras and insist that everything is under control. But the wider the smile, the bigger the lies.
You all right, Goro?
Yes. Why the sudden concern? Until you've kissed
and had to pay the cost. Have shared interests, you and I. Or have you forgotten?
Certainly not.
Good. Because catching lead in Night City is easier than catching a cold. And I need you alive.
I am alive and well, as you can see. You should worry about yourself.
Do you know how a lost heart feels? The thought of reminiscing. And how lips that taste of tears lose their taste for kissing. You don't know how hearts burn for love that cannot live yet never dies. Until you faced each dawn with sleepless eyes, you don't know.
My name is Arif Iqbal. Thank you for joining us.
They weigh round back.
Rogue, my sweet. This has got to be a misunderstanding.
I've no idea who jumped your team, but the claws? No, never. My boys know their place. I'm sorry, got to go. I have guests. V, so nice to see you. And your charming friend is?
Happen to be working together. That's all.
Takemura Goro desu. Okada-san, oai dekite kouhei desu.
Ah, a true gentleman. Ah, shame only that he's being hunted by all Arasaka's tin soldiers. And you, V, bring him to my door. Give me one reason why I shouldn't notify the proper authorities right away.
Eddie's is why. Always about Eddie's, Wakako. You want to make them? We got biz. Doesn't get any simpler.
So tell me, and mark well, I still have my phone at hand.
Need intel on the parade that's scheduled to come through Japantown.
So it's Arasaka again. What I fail to understand is, why come to me? Did Mr. Deshawn not come to the phone?
There's no time to waste.
Goro, remind me why Dex's fat, backstabbing ass is currently indisposed.
He is deceased.
Butchered and dumped at a landfill by some Arasaka goon. Real shame that.
That a threat I detect?
No threat, no. Asked why I couldn't reach Dex, I answered. Just facts, nothing more.
Good, because you would then have to join him.
Okada-san, our intentions are honorable. We need just information. It is a matter of life and death.
Everything's on the shards.
How much does this cost? My pockets are empty.
Clearly. My gift to you, it's free.
Okada-san, what is free often proves most costly.
Gonna take them or not?
For free? You sure?
Got my reasons, but patience, I got none. Japantown. Whole district is to be sealed off for the parade. Dashi platforms, the main attraction. They'll fly this way, high above street level. Along the parade route, balconies, footbridges, and vantage points affording good views. Hanako Arasaka, the guest of honor, will deliver her speech from the largest float. She'll do this exactly here. Got no idea about security, but given recent events, expect it to be tight. Our last parade? Arasaka undercovers infiltrated the crowd. Not to mention a smattering of sharpshooters, drones. And if that's not enough fun for one day, a net runner, one at least. They use the city CCTV to observe everything. Main access point, here. It's an old, automated control center. If you ask me, most useful by far. At the end, the floats will float out of Japantown, and we'll be left with trash up to our elbows that no one will collect. That's it. It's all I have.
It must be enough.
Then go. Be on your way.
Thanks, Wakako.
We appreciate this, Okada-san.
I need that co-processor. Well, what do you think? Like yesterday. It's not your problem anymore.
A delightful, mature woman. This information. It could be just what we need.
but I will try to investigate further. I will stay here some time and call some associates. The moment I learn something new, I will let you know.
Just low profile, okay? Don't start handing out autographs.
In fame, I could not overtake you if I tried. Be safe, B.
It's a good thing you answered. I could probably use your help.
Probably?
Fine. I could really use your help. Can we meet?
Deep breaths, Pan Am. Tell me what's going on.
Do you remember Saul? The leader of the clan I left?
Yeah. Had a falling out or something.
Doesn't matter right now. They nabbed him. This is just not suitable for a call, V.
Tell me when and where.
You don't know how good it is to hear that. Swing by the Aldecaldos camp. I'll explain it all.
The Aldecaldos? Thought you parted
Come
ways.
Here, let me have a
look, it's a long story. Just hurry over. I'm here.
First in our building.
Those city bastards still haven't sent anyone to fix it.
Mind my asking who your husband is? Actually, who are you?
I'd rather not discuss details over the phone. Please, meet with us. We'll explain everything. As I said, it's a rather delicate matter.
So hold on.
What's so delicate about the matter?
I'd rather discuss that in person, if you don't mind. Can we meet?
Can't commit just now. Busy like I've never been. It'd be unwise.
I see. Well, I shouldn't discount the urgency, but I guess we could wait a couple more days. We'd really rather work with you. Try to squeeze us in and give me a call.
Hey, V. Thanks for showing. Talking with Maiko is like a game of 3D chess. Don't let her derail you.
You seem a bundle of nerves.
I've a mind to kill the bastards with my bare hands. So yeah, you could say I'm a teensy bit nervous.
Some deets about her could be useful when I talk to her, don't you think?
No, leave the talking to me.
How do you aim to get her over to our side?
By telling the truth. About Evelyn, what happened and why.
Think that'll cut it?
No. Have to improvise from there.
I'm ready. Let's go.
Hold on. I'll open it.
Looks like you've come this way before. More than once.
I have. On occasion.
Easy as paella.
Follow me.
Judy Alvarez. I'd say it's great to see you, but I've never been one to lie. Also, I never like surprise parties, but you know.
Yep, bet I even know why.
Thought you'd hit rock bottom when you joined the Mox. Guess you've managed to stoop even lower now. You somehow never fail to lower my expectations. First you settle for the Mox, now murderers. I shudder to think what's next. Yes, V, I mean you.
Don't mind me. Just here to blend into the decor.
That's no reason. Why come at all?
To make sure Judy gets what she came for.
Jude would have had a better chance without you.
Judy has a proposal. About clouds.
Wanna come back? Done. Always valued your skills, you know that. Just don't get why you had to drag this loose end in here.
Stop treating dolls like meat and I'll consider it. But first things first. Clouds needs to be taken from the Tiger Claws.
Okay, look. It's clear what happened to Ev was traumatic.
Huh? I was convinced you didn't know.
That girl was asking for an unhappy ending. I was just surprised it took so long.
We gotta do something, or everyone'll end up like Evie. Woodman raped her while she was unconscious, then sold her like she was so much scrap.
Yeesh, you've always been unstable. Okay, since you seem more reasonable, care to explain what this is about?
Judy's idea. Think about it. Could work.
Well, Jude. See, you found a true and loyal fan.
Call me a murderer? You're right. I killed Woodman. I'd do it again in a heartbeat. And if I'd known what he did to Evelyn when she needed help, I wouldn't have gone so easy on him.
Tiger Claw bosses rule this place. Know how much I mean to them? About as much as you two and your problems mean to me. Reed, negligible.
Doesn't it make you wonder why you even work here?
Gonna pretend as if you two weren't ever here. For old time's sake, Judy. Literally moments from now, security's gonna figure out you're here. Got two options. Go out the way you came in, or get thrown out. And that's not a threat or figure of speech. Just a friendly heads up.
Had enough. I'm leaving.
Smart move. That went smoothly.
She totally blew us off.
Probably needs time to think. Couple of days, tops.
And you might be right. I'll call her tomorrow.
You have a history?
Way back, yeah. I think I just felt lonely.
Like everyone in Night City.
She was different then. And so was I.
Can't trust people that see everything as a numbers game. Line between patting you on the back as their friend and planning knifing you as their enemy is down to a decimal.
I know. Right there with you, Well, used to have a big crush on her. Took me a long time to realize who she really was. But still, honest or crooked, we need her. Just think, could have gone diving this morning.
A little unwinding do you good. Do me good too, actually.
I wouldn't have been unwinding, not exactly. Got an idea buzzing in my head, working it, but can't say if it'll amount to anything.
Yeah. You, a deck chair, and a Mai Tai with a cocktail umbrella? Somehow I don't see it.
No. Me and a deck chair is me mulling over coulda, shoulda, wouldas. Something I avoid right now. The ground floor.
To get out of this place. Waves in Tokyo, Sydney, and Paris. Their next stop is on your doorstep. Night City. Expecting unexpected.
I really don't understand what tits have to do with selling that garbage.
Can't say no to tits. Rest can go fuck itself.
Hey, if it works, I mean, blame the corpse all you want, but at the end of the day, it says more about us than them. Biz is biz and tits are biz.
It's like junk food. People don't buy it because they're gunk. They're just poor. Gotta get back to Maiko with something big.
Appealing to her sense of justice wasn't big enough?
Maiko only works with specifics.
For a minute there, I thought you were about to call it quits.
V, I go for days tuning virtues in a basement. Know what the chances are of somebody blowing my head off down there?
Minuscule?
Same as Maiko's empathy. Unlike you, I don't put myself out there. But this ain't over. Not yet.
You know, I'm also partial to specifics.
Uh-huh. So that's what matters. How many you'll drop, how much ammo you'll use, how many eddies it'll get you.
Art and dreams of freedom can't be everyone's food. Sometimes, you gotta deal with the dirt. So, what now?
Gotta think. We need more bodies, that's for sure. I'm gonna talk to the dolls.
I'll call you when I've got something.
See you later, V, and thanks.
Finally scrounged up enough eddies to pay you back in full.
Hold on to them, just in case. You need them more than me.
I'm not taking them all the way to my grave, Vic. Here. And thanks again for doing so much work on me without ever seeing an eddie.
That's what friends are for.
Come out!
How's biz going?
Can't complain. Corporals learned to keep their distance, and Sokka's back hiring lone mercs. They all gotta have the newest, shiniest implants.
Good thing you got Misty here to help. Handles your griping well.
Yeah, renting out her shop's the best decision I ever made.
Know what? Seems like you're the only person in Night City who's happy with his lot.
You get to a certain age, you drop all your illusions. Life just gets easier from there.
Got a few questions about Silverhand and this chip.
I'm no expert, but fire away. See what I can do.
How's it even possible, seeing him?
Well, that biochip is designed for users to communicate with constructs. It's just doing its job.
So I got Arasaka to thank.
You know, I wager you have the lowest net worth of any relic owner out there.
Tried to flatline me. Johnny did.
What?
What can I do to suppress him? You know, avoid my murder.
Well, long as you don't give him control, can't do too much harm. Of course, that won't necessarily be possible after some time.
And what then?
What do you say we don't let things get that far? Find a way to get rid of Silverhand, and fast.
Why am I reliving Johnny's memories?
You two share a brain now. He has access to your senses, perceptions, even some memories. Likewise, you've got a glimpse into his. After a while, won't even know whose is whose.
Was thinking about swapping some chrome. You got any new toys?
Have a look.
Hey, what's going on? I live right upstairs.
So keep on living. Stop minding other people's biz.
Dad, hold on. It's his neighbor.
Is there anything I can do?
Maybe. You know Barry at all?
More or less. Struck up a convo once or twice.
He's a friend from the precinct. Left the force not long ago. He broke down after his best friend died. We're worried he'll do something stupid.
Relax, Petrova. Barry's got nerves of steel. He's just a spiteful old bastard.
Mendez! Could you check on him when he's chilled down?
Sure, why not? It's not like we're miles apart.
Thanks. Just be patient. Cops falling in rough times can be touchy.
Let's see what I can do. Hey, Barry. Everything all right in there? I'm gonna take that as a yes. Try again later.
Frustrated with the uniform in the package?
Hey, look! Would you look at that? You see it too, right?
Either gone completely whacked or I'm having a mystical moment.
What's that chick's name? The one with the hair?
Misty? More likely a neuron misfire for Victor to check out. Or maybe I ask them both.
You blind?
Virginia Granchester, citing her most recent book.
Barry, am I remembering that right?
Who is it?
V, your neighbor from upstairs. Remember me? Talked about Preem rides. Back then you were pumped about the Mizutani Shion. I said it was for flash posers.
You don't forget a gonk thing like that.
You gave me this look. I was about to hightail it to the Badlands right then and there.
I remember. What do you want?
I just wanted to see what was shaking. Friends say you never leave your unit. I think I've got an inkling as to why. I've seen that look before. It's all too common among people like us.
Us? You don't look like a cop.
Badges don't get a monopoly on loss. You see death every day in my line of work. And you get used to it, of course. Until it hits someone you're close to.
You too. Come in.
I lost someone close to me, too. A damn good friend.
What do you mean, too? Wait. What's about Andrew? He told you about him. Best bud I ever had. Known him my whole life. Only person I could spill to without being judged.
I'm guessing things at the NCPD haven't changed a lick, huh?
One time, a Maelstrom ganger killed a young kid right in front of my eyes. For shits and giggles. I couldn't do shit. The son of a bitch had corporal protection.
Typical.
Our chief greases his palms with an anonymous donation. And guess what? Officially, kid blew his own brains out.
Right in front of your eyes.
Something died in me then. I couldn't do it anymore. A few months later, Andrew passed, and everything went to shit.
You didn't have anyone to unload on at work? How about Petrova and Mendez?
Petrova's a decent gal, but she's not good with this stuff. Mendez just doesn't get it. He thinks us blues need to be tough. Can't bear the sight of a kid getting murdered. Born with pussy genes, according to him.
But you told him about Andrew.
Honestly, thought about it a lot. Anyway, they don't know everything. Better that way.
Can you tell me how Andrew died?
Does it matter? Normally, from old age. It's no wonder, seeing as he was only a few years younger than my grandma.
Dying of old age? In Night City? That merits a monument. Whole world should gaze up at it in awe.
Ashbox and the niche will have to do.
Mendez doesn't know shit about life. Everyone's got their limits, even him. He just hasn't reached them. Not like you.
What if he's right, though? Maybe my genes are soft. Don't only the strongest survive?
If he felt nothing, that means his loss wouldn't have had any meaning.
I guess so. Thanks for the talk, V. I need time to take all this in.
Sure thing. Take care.
Forget about your word.
the streets that when Waco says golden, it's usually a turd wrapped in crepe paper.
It's a sticky situation.
Sticky? Wow, you're really selling this, Waco.
Jobs like any other. Just the client's will demanding.
Client's got every right to be demanding. What makes this one any different?
Wants everything to go exactly as planned. Willing to break the bank for it, too. Job like this needs your magic touch, V. Anyone less experienced it, just fuck it up.
Huh. Thanks for the vote of confidence. Now I'm sure it's a turd in crepe paper. So what's the spec?
Caroline Jablonski. Set off any buzzers for you. Murdered in cold blood. Made waves a few years back. They locked the guy up. But now there's a chance he can walk. Jablonski's family wants to balance the scales of justice for good. You'll finish him.
Kurt being proven guilty, meaning he deserves to die, truly?
Do I look like a criminal prosecutor to you?
What did he do exactly?
I'm not a beat reporter, neither. You want the job or not?
All right, I'm in.
Good. Client will be waiting for you by a car at the corner of 6th and Brandon.
Huh, in a car?
Client wants to tag along. Be there in person when you put a bullet through the guy's eye. Good luck.
Soak in that sun while you can. There's a cold front moving in.
It's you. Prepare for cooler. You talked to Barry? He finally decided to get his shit together?
For crying out loud, Mendez.
We had a little chat. He seems chilled, but seriously down in the dumps. He's got a bone to pick with Mendez.
What? So why doesn't he say so to my face?
Got no idea. Ask him yourself.
You fucking bet I will. His little temper tantrum must be over if he spilled to you. Only thing I don't know is whether to give him a taste of my fist or a shot of Boomalong.
Thanks for your help. This is for your trouble.